Today, we'll be diving into Qatalog 2. Now, Qatalog 2 is essentially the second version of Qatalog. And for those who don't know, I've done a full review of the initial version of Qatalog here on the channel. And very simply, Qatalog is a project management application that has a few differences and combines, I guess, the traditionality of a project management like Trello or Asana with a more no-code or flexible basis like Notion and Coda. Today, we're gonna look at the release statement from Qatalog 2 and what it means for the role and future of productivity. So welcome, if you're new here, my name's Francesco. Welcome to Keep Productive. Please do subscribe if you're brand new. Check out our new newsletters if you fancy in the link in the description. So Qatalog's a company that I've personally been interested in for quite a while. And I think Qatalog is a good example of what the next step of productivity could look like, in my opinion. I think the role that Qatalog plays right now is very small, but this new update is fairly interesting as a step forward for productivity and the embedding of AI in that. So what Qatalog is releasing today is something called Text to Product AI. And you're probably wondering, okay, I've heard of all this AI stuff. How is this different? And how is this something that could be beneficial? So this is different to a lot of AI that is out there at the moment, because what it does is it's focused on the core structure of workspaces versus being a generative AI system. So right now, if you go into Notion and you're luckily out of that wait list, you want to use AI, you start typing away and you can use it to prompt and improve it. Whereas this starts from the beginning. With this new Qatalog text to product AI feature, you can type in what you want a workspace to build around you. So for example, when I was on the call to demonstrate this product with them, I said a pet shop in San Francisco. And what it did is it built basically an entire structure and company layout based on this. Now this is pretty cool. And I guess it's probably what templates do, right? But what was different was it built objects around that. And that's what is different with this Qatalog setup, is it understands objects and it understands the sort of background and what you need for that. So when you go ahead and type in, say, media company in this department or real estate firm, what it will do is it will build the system around key aspects that the AI has picked out that are objects to what can be useful. And then you can further refine that in the experience, but from then on, your system is built around objects versus being built around your own structure, which something like AI might not understand, it might not allocate as something that's beneficial. So from the ground up, this structure is actually built using artificial intelligence versus the other way around, where it's plug and played or layered on top. Now this new version has a lot more abilities, and it's something that I'm probably gonna do Qatalog 2 full review on very soon. But this new update is something that's super interesting in the space as a way to fix the templatizing problem. And it probably causes a lot of issues for those who are potentially building Notion templates or community-based templates like that. But at the same time, it definitely solves an issue of actually setting things up for people that want to go and get started doing workload-based work, but not necessarily want to have that initial startup time. So I'll include a full announcement of what they had as a blog piece below, so you can read all about it. But it's definitely something that is super interesting in the space right now, and I think solves a real big need for that. And I like this concept of object-based structures in productivity, because I feel like that's the way that we build it from the ground up to introduce smart suggestions, improve the quality of our day plans, and also get it to do small errands for you that you might want it to do in the future, which is where I think this application is heading. So if you enjoyed this announcement update, we do more pieces of news about this, and you can find the link in description to subscribe to us if you fancy, or find out our newsletter, which is bi-monthly. I'm really excited to dive into more topics about this, so do subscribe to us, and we look forward to helping you to advance your productivity and help choose and find the best productivity applications for you. Thank you very much, folks, and I look forward to seeing you in a future video. Cheerio.